Well, hello again, and welcome to another episode of the Hyperion Adventures Podcast. I'm Tom. As always, I'm with my wonderful, intelligent, gorgeous, very hardworking, marvelous wife and co-host, Michelle.
You're so sweet, honey. I appreciate that. Thank you. And hi, everybody.
So good to have you with us. We are recording this episode on Sunday, November 12th, 2023. Hope you're all having a wonderful fall so far. Yes. Hope the time change this recent week didn't throw you off too badly.
Right. And to all our veterans, we say thank you and hope you had a nice celebration for Veterans Day.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for all that you've done for us and for this country.
Right.
Very much so. Perfect. Well said, Michelle, as as she always does. Thank you for joining us today. In the future, you can find us most everywhere you get podcasts. However, the very best place to find us is on our own website, HyperionAdventuresPodcast.com. And while you're there,
we invite you to sign up for our newsletter.
Please sign up for the newsletter. It's a great way to be just involved more in the Hyperion Adventures podcast world.
Get some news.
Yep, get some news. Maybe a link to a contest that you don't know about. Mm-hmm. Maybe just, you know, have some fun on there. Right. We just want to get it out there. And we want you to be involved with it as well, because Michelle's doing a great job with it. I'm doing a little piece of it as well, but it's mostly Michelle.
You're so sweet. You do a great job.
Nah, and I appreciate not nearly as good as you. Not nearly as good as you. Yeah. Also, we are on social media. We are on Twitter.
X.
At Hyperion Podcast. No one calls it X. It's Twitter.
Everybody now calls it X.
No. Everybody out there who calls it X, raise your hand. See? Nobody. Nobody. Not even you raised your hand.
Well, I do call it X. I didn't realize. Yeah, my brain's, I guess, not working. Thank you.
Anyway, we're on whatever that is, at Hyperion Podcast, Facebook, Instagram, and Threads at Hyperion Adventures Podcast. If you are on Facebook, come on over and join us for some good, positive Disney energy fun on our Hyperion Adventurers Facebook group. Also, we are on YouTube. If you want to find us there, we're at Hyperion Adventures Podcast. And if you ever want to contact us for any reason, like so many of you did this week to help us out with today's topic, we are at HyperionAdventuresPodcast@gmail.com.
Yeah. And, you know, we love the participation that people have had, like Tom said, this week in our episode. So thank you to those of you who wrote in. But also, you feel free to just say hi on a Gmail, or if you have a question or a suggestion of something you want us to talk about.
Yep. Well, we appreciate interaction however it comes through us, whether it be through the Gmail, through the social media, whatever. We just like talking with you.
Exactly.
Yeah. Now, before we get into this week's show, you know, we always like to take a look at the week that was, because we are the Disney podcast of positivity, and we like to focus on those positive moments, both this week and from the previous week. We like to focus on our favorite things from the week. We call it my favorite thing from this week. And when we do this, we always start with Michelle, because she's wonderful, fantastic, all things marvelous in the world. You know, she does the best lists. She definitely does the best research, and she has the best tips. You know that week in and week out. The other thing she almost always has is the best, my favorite thing from this week. So Michelle, what is your favorite thing from this week?
I guess there was a couple to choose from, and I'm trying to figure out which one am I going to say. I guess I'll say the fact that we purchased Disneyland tickets this week for
true.
Our upcoming trip. And I know we still need to secure some things with reservations, etc., but having those makes it that much feeling closer and very exciting. Yes. Very exciting.
We're actually getting very close now. We were within 60 days from when we will be actually heading out to Southern California once again for the first time in over a year for you, longer than that for me, since I've been out there to see family, but also to, of course, visit Disneyland, because, you know, it's us.
Right.
So we have to do that. We have a Run Disney race out there, and we are trying to make the plans for Disneyland. We're also going to be checking out the new DVC villas at the Disneyland Hotel.
So
that's going to be a lot of fun.
And in fact, that was also one of my favorite things of the week that I was going to say is we did get a room a day earlier that we were trying to get.
Right. We had to shuffle our schedule a little bit due to flights.
Right. You know. And we weren't sure we were going to get one of the rooms earlier on, but that came through. So, yay.
We're good. Yes. That is good. So, yes, exciting. Michelle's doing some great work trying to get us all situated with reservations for our trip so we can do as much as possible and as little as possible while we're out there as well. But looking forward to that for sure.
Yeah. What about you?
I got a few things from this week. First of all, there's one thing.
I bet I can guess one of them.
Well, I'm sure you can. but the other one, well, the other couple. One is that we received some notice that we may have an exciting upcoming guest. Now, it's not locked in yet, so we don't want to, it's not 100% locked in yet, so we don't want to completely jinx it. And we also don't want to spoil it by telling you what it's all about. It is something. About something we've been talking a lot about recently, but if it comes through, which we think it might in here in just a few weeks, it's going to be very exciting. We think you're going to love it too. So keep your fingers crossed that this all comes through as we're thinking it might.
Right.
Also,
we're talking Pat and Charles from Carver Persuasion,
of course,
right?
Yeah. No, that's the opposite.
No, it's
that
not.
Is the exact opposite of what we're talking about here.
You're so bad.
I wanted to bring up that Michelle has done a wonderful job throughout our house. We've been getting a lot of our artwork up throughout the house. We have so much Disney and other artwork and stuff, and we've been trying to figure out places for it for so long. Well, Michelle has finally put it all together, and she's doing a fantastic job putting some of it up throughout the house, including our guest room, which we're calling the quote-unquote animation room, which... maybe at some point I'll release a little video of some of the artwork that we have hanging in there. But Michelle's done a fantastic job of making our house just that much prettier, just like Michelle is that much prettier.
You're so cute. But thank you. Yeah, I'm glad that we are finally getting some of that together. I had been waiting on for some frames as well. So, it's exciting. And looking forward to some other art that's not up there yet, because we do have some... some kind of collectible stuff, too, that we need to get some great frames for.
We still don't have the studio / office together yet. That is the other thing that's going to be... we have so much stuff to go in here. We're trying to figure out where that's going to go. Is quite a chore, but I know Michelle will do a fantastic job with that, just as she does with everything else.
You're sweet.
And finally, yes, you guessed it. Michelle guessed it. Yes, of course I have to talk about... well, I'm not going to really talk about it, but I have to say how... amazing, fantastic, spectacular. The season, possibly series finale for Loki was. It was, blew me away. Mm-hmm. So good. So amazing. All the way through season two. Even season one was fantastic. Season two was a near masterpiece. Right. It was so well done. That Loki finale blew my socks off.
Yeah. I agree with you. It was pretty spectacular. You know, going in, it's like... it seemed like there were a lot of loose ends to tie up, and, you know, again, no spoilers, but I thought they really brought things together nicely. And it was, as I say each week, not predictable, at least from my perspective. I didn't expect some of the things that happened, and made it very, very intriguing.
Yeah. They tied a lot of stuff up, but they also left some things dangling out there that are very, very interesting. And I can't wait to see where this all goes here within the Marvel universe as we go forward. Hopefully we're getting to go see the Marvels soon, because I've heard some good thing. I know it's not gotten like the most amazing reviews, but from a lot of people who I've seen talk about going to it, they're like, it's a fun movie.
Yeah, that they're enjoying it.
So I'm excited for that. I always like to judge for myself. Right. I think you do the same. We don't judge just based on what anybody else says. If we're excited for a movie, we're going to go see it no matter what the critics say. And then we'll decide for ourselves.
In some movies, there's just so much in it that you need to appreciate the details by seeing it more than once.
Yeah. I mean, plus we love all the characters. We loved Captain Marvel. We loved Miss Marvel, the series. We're getting ready to watch that again as we're getting ready to go see that film. And we loved Photon, Monica Rambeau, of course, from WandaVision.
Yes.
So we're excited to see how that all plays out. And like I said, people are saying like it's a fun ride, which is good. I want to go to the theater and have a fun ride.
Right. You know, it doesn't always have to be so deep.
Yeah. for sure. And it could be, I don't know. I haven't, no one spoiled it for me yet.
Right.
There could be some significant depth involved with
sure.
it too. I just
sure.
don't know, but right. I'm excited to find out for sure. Now on to this week's show. We have lots of stuff for you this week, including we're talking a lot about Disney Marvels in today's show. Well, your chance for your own Marvels experience is happening at Disney parks around the globe. We'll tell you all about that. Disney Cruise Line once again takes some big honors home. We'll tell you all about that too. And if you're looking for an extravagant, upscale way to spend New Year's Eve beyond the looking glass at the Walt Disney World Resort, well, we've got the party for you. Maybe not so much for your bank account, but definitely for you. But that's later. Let's go ahead and get to our marvelous, wishful main topic of the week. So yes, for this week's main topic, as we already discussed, the Marvels came out this week.
Right.
We're very excited about it. We're also maybe even more excited in just a couple weeks here for Disney Wish, the new animated film from the Walt Disney Animation Studios to come out, because it looks brilliant. And the early returns from that, from people who have seen the premieres and the previews and everything, have been phenomenal. Very excited for that film. They've been releasing music from it almost on a weekly basis. It all sounds spectacular.
Right.
Couldn't be more excited for it.
For sure. And, you know, some of the things that we've been seeing, whether it was at Destination D23 or since then, is looks like great, rich characters.
Yeah.
So that's very, very awesome.
Looks like it's going to fit right in with the tradition of Walt Disney animation.
Right.
Their musical films, of course, that are some of the most classic in all our hearts. Very excited for that. And like we already talked about, very excited to see the Marvels for sure. So we thought, how can we put this all together into an episode? And we thought, you know what? Let's kind of put it and make it a thing that's kind of a interactive show.
Right.
You know, make it like, what are your Marvels, Disney Marvels, and wishes. What at Disney makes you marvel, makes you kind of say wow, impresses you when you go? And what are your wishes going through the rest of this year and onward into 2024, maybe even beyond? What do you wish for as we go forward? And we wanted it to be interactive when we got some wonderful responses from people.
Yeah. So appreciate people sending us their information so that we could share it on this episode.
Mm-hmm, for sure. But before we get to all of yours, of course we need, it's all about us here. We need to get ours.
It's just a way to start the ball.
Our Marvels and our Disney Marvels and wishes. And then if we're going to start that, then we're also going to start with Michelle, because you know she's going to have the best. Mm. She has the best list. We've talked about that. She does the best research. We've talked about that. You hear later, she has the very best tips. I'm sure she's going to have the best Disney Marvels and wishes. So Michelle, what is your Disney Marvel and what is your Disney wish?
Oh, so I thought this was a top five.
It can definitely be a top five. I don't think I have five, but for Michelle, it can definitely be a five.
It is. I did do five, and I remarkably didn't do A's and B's. So I do have just five of each one, but maybe I should just give you my top one or two.
Give me whatever you want to give me, honey. I just appreciate you. I love you dearly. And I love that it's so often with this show, it's like we come up with an idea for a topic and we're like, yeah, we'll just go with it. And then we end up turning on the mics and we're like, well, we thought it was this.
Right.
Like, I thought it was this. And so we're just going with what we got. So it's we're mostly predictable on this show, but sometimes not so much.
I guess the predictable part is that we're probably not going to understand the topic same way.
Our own topic.
Our
we
interpretation.
Will not understand our own topic.
Right.
Sure.
It won't be interpreted the same way.
Anyway, so go ahead.
All right. Well, I guess since I have five, and none of them will take a long time, and I could, I guess, focus on some more than others. But for things that marvel me about Disney, my number five would have been the Happily Ever After fireworks show. I just think that is so top notch, and just how it makes you feel every time we see it, even though we've seen it more than once, it just brings out those great emotions. But I'm also very much looking forward to Luminous. So from what I've seen about that, it looks like it has some great potential of also being very heartwarming. I think the concept that they're having where bringing in themes that connect everybody, things that people as a human race, we all feel and experience. I think that's intriguing, and I think will be pretty amazing.
Let's face it, even the always up for interpretation, what you consider the worst nighttime Disney spectacular is still pretty darn good.
Right, exactly.
In comparison to some other things that are out there. You know, we've talked about it with friends, with listeners, that you go like just to your random neighborhood or, you know, community fireworks show. And it's just kind of like because you're so used to how magnificent Disney does it, how well they do it, that, yes, fireworks are always good. They're always going to give you a little bit, but does anybody do it as well as Disney? Not really.
Except San Diego, the 4th of July. Where
when they lit them all off at
all
once.
All at the one time, yeah. The whole show and the finale.
Fireworks went off in two.
Yes. Yeah. funny. So next up, my number four Marvel thing is how amazing the Mandalorian seasons were. I mean, they had great characters, intriguing storylines, and it just really seemed to take off and hit so many different genre of people. Like, not everybody likes Star Wars. Hard to believe, but there are people who don't. And yet, I think there was something about these characters and the story that still connected with people who might not have been fans of Star Wars.
That's a good point. Yeah. Or just kind of on the periphery.
Right.
Fans, not necessarily, you know, they're not Pat and Charles. They're not deep diving into Star Wars.
Right. My number three Marvel is the food at Remy's on Disney Cruise Line. And I've said this before. I don't know the words to use to describe just how elevated food can be. And that's the experience you have when you go to Remy's. It's like no other food that you ever tasted. You can think of the most luxurious restaurant you ever went to, and I don't know. I guess if you go to someplace really special in
Victoria and Albert or something.
Right, something like that. Or even someplace very special in, you know, New York.
Yeah,
several
Michelin-star restaurants. Michelin star,
right,
yeah.
But for the most of us, if you think of even your the best restaurant, it probably doesn't even come close to how intricate and amazing flavors that they get out of food.
Well, it's not just even the flavors, it's the presentation and it's the service as well.
True.
I mean, it all comes together into a one magical, expensive, but magical meal on Remy on board Disney Cruise Line. So what you're talking about. And I agree.
Cool. Winding down here, my number two is it marvels me at how we can connect. When I say we, I mean all of us, not you, just you and me, honey, can connect so closely with the Disney characters that even in an animated feature, it can bring out the emotions. We can cry and, you know, typically growing up, you would think of cartoons and they're silly and fun, but how the heart in Disney animation really comes through.
Yeah, how well the animators do at bringing out that emotion. And then the voice actors as well to, you know, also put that out there. The combination of everything, the editing, the animation, the backgrounds, the voice acting itself, the story.
Yeah, I was just going to say, storytelling. Yes.
How they were able to put that together. And, you know, again, you know, so many of these films, even films that maybe people, there's lots of us that, that's not my favorite Disney film, but for somebody out there, when that one's not their favorite, it is their favorite.
Right.
And they always draw something out of you.
Exactly. All right. And finally, my number one thing that I marvel about is the Disney Studios in Burbank. I mean, this is a place that Walt built after Snow White, you know, he was able to, afford to expand and build this college-like campus, and that so many decades later, it still has that special feel to it. I'm sure, you know, the people who work there could talk about that, but even just us who have toured it a couple times, you can just feel that it's a special place, like an honor grounds. Right. I don't know how to describe it, but it does have that college feel and look to it. But there's just something about it that is so amazing, and yeah, you feel the history, and it feels so special.
Yeah, and we, like you just mentioned, we've been blessed to be able to go there a handful of times to visit it for various reasons, to tour it, to go to holiday parties, right, to see screenings of films. Right. It's been, and each time it's been wonderful, spectacular. Highly recommend if you're a Disney fan, you make it to the West Coast or you live near the West Coast. If you become a D23 member, they often have these events there, and make it a goal. Yes. Put it on the bucket list from wherever you are across the country to try and plan out a trip to get there. And especially if you can do the entire tour and view Walt's office, it's pretty incredible.
Right, right.
Pretty incredible. You will always remember it.
Exactly.
Very good. Good point.
All right. So what about your Marvel?
So I actually have three. I didn't go a top five, but I do have three Marvels. Right. So I guess that at least it balances out a little bit between the two of us. Some of the things that I marvel at with Disney. And this kind of alludes to some things you talked about, some of them. The way all the Disney cast members, they make you feel special, even though you're one of thousands of people possibly run into the day, or thousands of people at the parks, the resorts, or whatever. But they can make you personally feel special.
That's a good point. Right.
The cast members are amazing, fantastic. They do such a wonderful job, and they treat us all so well. We're very lucky to have Disney cast members time we visit a Disney park.
Right. And I think that's something that makes the park so unique that, you know, pretty much everybody talks about them. Mm-hmm. You know, good one.
Thank you. And building off of that, the interaction between the characters, especially within Avengers Campus, let's say, with guests, it'd be so easy to do it where they would just, you know, you walk up, you wait in a queue, you get up there, you're with a character, they snap a quick picture, okay, on your way. Right, not that that doesn't happen occasionally with some characters, but especially within Avengers Campus, but often other characters as well. They connect with you.
Right.
And especially the little ones. They connect with the little ones so well. That is just, one, it's amazing to watch, but it's also amazing to experience. And it just gives you that special feeling. And there's a reason why you want to go take these pictures with these characters so often.
Right. For sure. For sure. Like you're saying. And I think, you know, kind of supplemental with that is the PhotoPass cast members too, because they also help draw things out before taking their pictures, especially with the characters. You know, even when you're with characters that don't talk out loud to you, that they find ways to make your interaction with that character, to either describe something or just get involved in that, so that you feel like it's almost like they're telling you something.
Right. It is really impressive what they do. Those characters.
Right,
And just makes us so happy to, when we get, we're not ones that will sit in a super long queue for photos, but when we find one that's the right size or a character that we want to meet, it's always fantastic. And either way, we will often stop and just watch people interact with their characters, because we find it fascinating to see how the interactions go, because they're always magical.
Exactly.
For sure.
And highlighting Avengers Campus, I think it's appropriate, because it does seem like that is by far the best experiences we've seen in terms of interactions.
Well, I think they have a little bit of a step above many of the other character meet and greets, because so many, as you were mentioning, the character meet and greets are characters that don't necessarily speak.
Right.
You know, so, I mean, yes, they do a spectacular job of getting that interaction despite that.
Right.
But most of the characters within Avengers Campus are face characters that will be talking with you.
Right, true, true.
It's spectacular. Yeah. Fantastic. It's
exactly.
So good. So good. So, Finally, my third one is I marvel at the way Disney can easily make me feel virtually every emotion every True. Time I go. It doesn't matter if it's at the parks, the nighttime spectaculars, yes. the attractions themselves, right. the films. It's all there. All the emotions. They right. know how to do it. They know how to do it. This is, again, the building on something Michelle discussed a little bit ago. They right. know how to do it through story, through, you know, imaging,
right.
through artwork, through character experiences, whatever. They can make it into this phenomenal feeling that, you know, puts you on this roller coaster of emotions that
right.
just, you know, when it's all said and done, makes you feel so good.
Yes. I mean, in some of the things you're saying there too, there's a lot of behind the scene things that help that along. I know we did a series one time about like background music and, mm-hmm. and other types of plants and imagery and things that you take for granted when you're there, but they are all part of getting you into the story that's mm-hmm. being told at the yeah. parks.
They just do such a magnificent yeah. job of that, and I appreciate it so much. So those are my Disney marvels. Now let's move on to our Disney wishes. What are we looking forward to? What are we hoping for in the rest of 2023 and on into 2024? Back to Michelle. You have a top five?
I have a I do couple, have a top five.
But I don't have five.
So. All right. Well, I mean, and this one I'm not counting in my top five. I think everybody would want world peace. All right. Let's just put that out there.
Really do want world peace.
Right.
Really, really do.
A quirky one that I had, and for people who don't know the rumor, they may think, oh my God, that is morbid and sick. But and part of me kind of wishes that the rumors that Walt had been frozen were true.
They're not?
From what I read, no. They've been. But it is amazing how something like that really took on a life that it became, you know, something that people were believing in forever, I guess. But anyways, I don't count that one either. My top five wishes is number five would be that the Haunted Mansion Nightmare Before Christmas overlay would come to Walt Disney World. Mm-hmm. I think that would be amazing. That they will do a season two of the Obi-Wan series.
Mm, I hope for that too.
Yeah. My number three is I wish I could win a Disney sweepstakes that would allow us to stay in the tower for a week on the Disney Treasure.
Oh,
that yeah. tower suite looks pretty yeah, amazing.
That'd be pretty cool. That's the Figment one, right?
Right. right. Yeah, well, it, I cool. think it incorporates several things of the parks because I think Small World theming is also part of that.
Some of the Mary Blair stuff.
Right, and, right. My number two would be that I could visit every Disney park in the world. Mm. You know,
we're going to try.
Yeah, yeah. And my number one wish is that I could have lunch with Tony Baxter and or Joe Rohde and just really hear some of their stories and just listen to them and just be amongst these iconic legends.
Yeah. We've been lucky enough to, you know, just a little quick meet mm-hmm. with Tony Baxter.
Right.
Just a quick photo with him, but he was couldn't have been nicer. Yes. I've heard great things about Joe Rohde. Mm-hmm. Some friends of ours have been lucky to bump into him at the parks. I think it's specifically the Nomad Lounge.
Right, right.
We haven't been able to meet Joe Rohde yet. But,
right, right.
Yeah, talked about a couple impressive human right, beings that have exactly. done some amazing things with the parks.
Right.
For sure, that would be fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, so that's my list, my good. Wishes. What about you?
My wish, well, I'm going to say it's just to continue doing this podcast with you, my sweetheart.
You know,
I've really enjoyed this. It's been, gosh, almost 5.5 years now Hard that we've been believe. Doing this
yes.
show. And I enjoy it every single week. I love doing it every single week. And
likewise.
I hope we continue doing that. And that we have all you Hyperion adventurers along with us along right. the way as we continue to do this. And we appreciate you so very much. Thank you for
sure.
you know, being a part of this show, whether this is your first time listening or whether you've listened to us since the beginning.
Right.
Hopefully we've improved a little since the beginning. I don't know.
And it still amazes me that we did. We went from just starting a podcast to having so many listeners and so many great friends that we've gained friends. As a part of that. But yeah.
The friends we've made is phenomenal.
Yeah, priceless.
You know, that's so true. It's been amazing. you know, my other wish is that we have some magnificent days up ahead with my family in the parks. Mm-hmm. You know, they're coming right. out here. Just actually, my mother's coming out this coming week.
Right.
And the rest of my family is coming out next week. And we're going to be out at Walt Disney World on Monday with them. And yes. then, of course, in January, we have some plans to go out and do Disneyland together right. with all of them. So I'm wishing for some magnificent days out there, some good weather and
hopefully,
some
yeah.
good fun times for sure. Right. But it'll just be good to hang out with them for sure. And then, of course, I brought it up already a little bit. You know, hopefully we'll connect with many, many more of you over this next
right.
2023 and on into 2024. You know, some of you we've been lucky enough to connect with a little bit
right.
out in the parks. Some of you that we just have not quite meshed up yet.
Right.
Hopefully that's going to happen this year because we love you all. We appreciate you all. And we thank you all for you know, helping make this show. We'd be probably doing this show if it's just the two of us talking to one another.
Right.
It's fun. But, you know, the fact that you are giving us some interaction back, giving us some feedback back helps right. inspire us
to
keep doing this show. So yes. we appreciate you very much. And we want to connect with you also in the parks.
That's true. Very well done. Great, great list, baby.
Thanks. Thanks. So those are our Disney marvels and wishes. Mm-hmm. We do have some of our listeners as well. Thank right. you, everybody who yes. wrote in to us, whether it be through social media or the Gmail account. Michelle, why don't you kick us off with a few that got sent to you?
Okay. So this one comes from Dr. Jacqueline, who's on Twitter at PixieDustPhD. For Marvel, she put, how scores or songs from some of their movies and attractions can instantly transport her, like Finding Nemo, Inside Out, HEA, and how special it is seeing Mickey and Minnie walk around at Hollywood Studios during extended hours.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think it... You know, we've gotten to be able to see that so much more at Disneyland, where we've seen mm-hmm. so many more walking characters, even ones that you don't think walk around so
right.
much. And sometimes, yeah, the nighttime parties is when that happens more often yes. than not. But yeah, it's a little different because you're so used to queuing up into a location to get a meet and greet or a photo with some of these characters.
Right.
So when you actually see them walking through the parks, it's breathtaking
right.
in many
exactly.
ways.
Yeah. Yeah, great.
Yeah, very good.
Great
Thank
one.
You, Dr. Jacqueline.
Yes, and her wish is for good health, great food, and selfishly, she wants the Poly DVC Tower to be in the existing association as the Poly DVC Studios and Bungalows. We're right there with you, Dr. Yeah. Jacqueline. We hope that too.
Hopefully it fits. It looks a little weird right now. I'm not going to pass judgment on that tower, the new towers yet, you know, until they actually add the decor
right.
and touches mm-hmm. or anything, but it's a little, stands out a little bit right now.
Right,
like a sore
right,
thumb.
Yes.
I have faith in the Disney Imagineers that they're going to make that thing fit as well as possible.
Right.
But we'll see.
Yes.
I do appreciate, as someone, like, we love the DVC studios for the two of us.
Right.
But it gets a little crowded for multiple days when we bring our son with us.
Yes.
You know? So we like having a one bedroom from time to time when
right,
he's with us.
Right.
They don't have those for DVC members, for anybody. I think they don't. Do they have any suites at the Poly? I don't think they even have any suites at all at the Poly.
Well, I think they're suites, you know, and they have like club level, but I do
they
think
have
they have
level.
Suites, but I don't think they are like with a full kitchen and things like that, right. that you would think of a DVC resort to have.
Either way, we like having when we're the three of us in the room, we like having the little more space that the one bedroom brings us when we're
right.
staying. I mean, one night's fine, but when we're staying multiple days, we like to have that. And so being able to have him with us and experience
right.
one of our favorite resorts in a one bedroom suite at the Poly is exciting for
yes,
us.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, definitely.
But yes. Please fit the theming.
Yes.
Please fit the Poly theming. That's what we're hoping for. Do you have another one?
I have several more. I didn't know if you wanted to go back.
Go ahead and go for one more, and then I'll go for a couple.
Okay. Well, Charles from Conversations Podcast, which we talked about, and you can find
Who?
Them.
Never heard of them.
Ha ha. You can find them on X at Swations.
No one knows where that is. You can find them on Twitter.
Okay. Anyways, for Marvel, he said what wowed him was the Beatles Now and Then special.
Ooh.
Totally,
wow, that's
totally agree. Yeah. Yeah, that was
it's pretty cool.
Definitely cool. And his wish for the future of Disney is getting Star Wars movies back in the theaters.
Yeah, That would be good. Yeah. It's been a while.
Yeah.
And we keep hearing about possibilities and then them being canceled. Or really would like to see some firm Star Wars films back in the theaters. Although I'm fine with, I like the series. I think you can go more in depth in series.
Right,
but
right.
Yes, still there's something kind of cool about the history of going to the theaters and,
right.
you know, and having it all kick in, you know, and
right.
the music start and everything. It's true. Well,
and definitely how the sequel ended does leave like an intriguing what's next kind mm-hmm. of feel.
Yeah. So we'll see. There's been talk, you know, they've semi-announced things.
Right.
But we haven't seen anything on paper for sure yet. So let's just keep our fingers crossed that something happens
right.
in the very near future for sure. Very nice. Thank you, Charles.
Yes. All right. Who do you have?
So I'll start off with Scott in Minnesota. He wrote into us, when I'm in the parks, I marvel at the immersiveness of the guest experience and the Imagineering that goes behind all of it. I can sit and enjoy being taken to any number of fantastical places, and at times I can sit and try and figure out how they just took me there. It always amazes me how thorough the Imagineers are and no detail is missed. Agreed.
True. For sure. Totally. Yep.
He said we can leave this part out because it's a little behind the curtain. So if you want to skip this real quickly, if you don't like any behind the curtain talk, this isn't anything. I'll tell you right now, it's not anything super revealing here. But you know, if you want to skip ahead by a minute or so, go ahead. He said, also, it marvels me at how well the character actors are at knowing every little detail about their characters' backstories and how committed they are to staying in character. Although I did make I did make Daisy chortle out loud once, one of my proudest Disney moments.
That must have been something. Yeah. But yeah, that is so cool. I know that I've heard stories too of like when they're on break, some of the things that they do. I mean, in terms of like practicing the autographs so mm-hmm. that it always looks, is that Pluto always gets the same autograph?
That's right.
Every time.
Yeah. Very much, because he's Pluto.
Yes.
That's what he does.
Yes. Good one.
He said, my wish is, well, I'm struggling to find a wish to wish. I mean, there's always to win the $1 billion Powerball and move yeah. out to the resorts. Yes, I think we'd all like that. But that seems too obvious. Maybe my wish is for them to bring Haunted Mansion Holiday to
yes.
Florida. Is that too much to ask? Am I see you real soon, Scott in Minnesota?
Right. Nice. Good, good, so, good.
Very
one.
Good.
Yes.
This one came in from Sean in Southern California. He said, I marvel at the way Disneyland changes its decor to meet each and every season so perfectly and instantly makes you feel that holiday spirit.
That is true.
Yeah.
They do. They really capture it.
Yeah.
I mean, I know we get some of that with Epcot's festivals. Mm-hmm. You get some of that seasonal feel, but I do agree that...
outside of that, the festival, the holidays, obviously that is a very seasonal feel. The other, they make you feel like the flower and garden is very spring. I mean, it's not
yes.
directly spring, but
right.
it feels very spring because
right.
of all the
right.
topiaries
yes.
and the flower, fresh yes. flowers and everything else. They kind of capture seasons in different ways.
Right, right. Food and wine, you feel like harvest time.
You know, like how it's more distinctive in like Magic Kingdom, like, you know, for Halloween season, all the jack-o'-lanterns
right.
and
yes.
pumpkins come out and all right. the fall colors. And then
right.
you get into the holiday season and those all come out. And if you go to Disneyland, you get to New Orleans Square and all mm-hmm. the Mardi Gras stuff comes
right,
out,
sure.
which is always cool as well.
Right.
So, that's kind of a direct... Sean went on to say, my wish is to visit Disney World for the first time and maybe even a Disney cruise. A guy can dream, right?
Nice.
Yeah, I hope so. Yes. Hope you get out, Sean.
Yeah.
Let us know if you do.
We'll connect.
Definitely. For sure.
Yeah.
Back to you, Michelle. Who you got next?
Okay. To our Gmail listener, Cheryl wrote for Marvel. She said, like Tom has mentioned a couple times, how special Once Upon a Studio was.
Yeah.
That was pretty.
Good.
Thought that was cool. And
I agree, Cheryl.
Her wish is to wake up Christmas morning at a Disney hotel, preferably Shanghai, but any would be great.
Shanghai. Wow.
Again,
I know they do holiday stuff, but I don't know if I directly associate holiday with Shanghai,
true.
But that's cool.
Maybe just big wishes.
I would like to wake up. I don't care what day it is.
Right.
I'd like to wake up in the Shanghai Disney Resort Hotel. It's for sure at some
exactly.
point. Yeah. Very cool. I like that. That was Cheryl?
Yes.
Thank you, Cheryl.
Yeah. I guess if you want me to do one more here.
One more.
Another Gmail account is Chris. For Marvel, they put the immersive Disney animation experience, and they just couldn't believe how incredible it was and how it made you feel so much a part of it.
Wow, so. Very cool. I like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And for Wish, that we could experience Avengers Campus at Walt Disney World.
Oh.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people wish they could.
Contractually, not. Well, but I mean, as stockholders, Disney makes money for not having it.
It's true. It's true.
But Universal pays them.
Boy, it would be nice to be able to have some of those experiences in the parks. But right. It is also nice to kind of have that special, like, you know, that's that one thing that gets you out to Disneyland.
Right.
You know, whether it be, you know, okay, they're not going to ever do the Haunted Mansion holiday at the Magic Kingdom version of Haunted Mansion.
Right.
So maybe that drives you to go to Disneyland to check that out. Or maybe it's Avengers Campus that drives you there, or to Disneyland Paris.
True.
Because who has Avengers Campus as well? I mean, there's something to be said for having those things only in specific parks. But yeah, I would love to have more Marvel influence in Walt Disney World.
Right.
For sure.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, love the Guardians of the Galaxy.
Right.
All day long. Fantastic. I'd love to see a little bit more, but
exactly.
I don't know if that'll ever get worked out. That could be definitely a wish.
That's true.
Sure.
So thank you, Chris.
Very nice. Very nice. Thank you, Chris. I've got one here from Sarah in Texas. She said her marvel is, I'm always amazed by the castle. As soon as I get a glimpse of it, I know I'm home.
Aww,
isn't that true?
That is true.
So true. And her wish, she said, my wish is to get more chances to visit that castle in the next year.
Yes.
For sure. I get that, especially.
Yeah, Texas is not too far, so.
It's not that far.
Do it.
Not that far. I don't know. It depends what side. I don't know where in Texas there is.
Right.
I've traveled across Texas. Some of it could be pretty far away. You might as well be, you're almost in California on one end of Texas. The other end of Texas, not so far.
That's true. That's true.
This one, back to the conversations, guys. Ooh. This is from Pat. He said, what makes me Miss Marvel, MS Marvel, Miss Marvel, / say wow, time and time again, the views down Main Street as the fireworks explode over the castle.
Yes.
Every time.
Yes, for sure.
He doesn't have a wish, but I'll just speak for Pat and probably like that he's from Philadelphia, that his Eagles finish out and actually win the Super Bowl this year. I'll just put that in there for Pat.
That's so nice of you to give somebody their wish.
Yes.
Or at least
I think
not
he would granted. Agree with
I'm
me
not saying
that.
Granted,
I've
yeah.
heard him talk about the Eagles enough that I believe he would agree that that's one of his wishes for 2023, 2024.
That's funny.
And I got one more here. The last one I got from Jessica in Jacksonville. She said, her marvel, I'm always amazed at the Disney characters, how just seeing Mickey and Minnie or the princesses can instantly make me turn back into a little girl seeing them for the first time.
Nice.
Me too. I turn back into a little girl every time I see the characters too. 100%.
Well, you know, like I've said in the past, Disney gives you permission, no matter what your age is, to be a kid. And mm-hmm. so I think I totally agree.
Mm-hmm. And her wish, she said, my wish is for a nighttime parade to return to Magic Kingdom.
Yes.
I think that's so many people's wish.
Oh, my
wish.
God, yes.
Especially the electrical parade. The parade. I need it, LOL. Yes, yes. I've heard that many times. I think people would paint the night, Spectro Magic.
Right.
Main Street Electrical Parade. I think people would just be happy. You know, something brand new.
Right.
I think people would love to see a new nighttime parade
at
Magic Kingdom or anywhere in the Walt Disney World Resort.
Right, right. Exactly. Totally agree.
Do you have any more?
I do have one more from Tony, the Disney dad.
Ah, Tony.
Yeah. He said, I marvel at the magic Walt created. Disney's most extraordinary magic is the ability to make us forget about the real world and live in a fantasy land. Whether that's through vacations, movies, or experience, they do it like no other.
Nice.
Totally true.
Very true,
totally
Tony.
True.
Thank you.
And he said, I wish to actually spend more than 15 minutes and get a picture with Tom and Michelle in 2024. Yes, Tony, that has to happen. We have to make that wish be granted.
I actually think
we want it to.
Tony's like going to be every time he goes to Walt Disney World, it's like the worst time for us.
We're
either out of the country on a cruise or something, or it's like this time we have family coming to town,
right.
And he's going to be there right before we're going, you know, and then we're going after, directly afterwards, and we're not going to be able to mesh up with them again this time.
Right, so I know.
But we are. It's going to happen, Tony. We're going to have a good sit-down meal or, you know, a nice adult beverage.
Exactly.
And we are going to take a picture this time, because the last time we got together, it's like we got together, we talked for a little bit, and then we're like, okay, we're going to go do our separate things. And then I texted him like an hour later. I'm like, I can't believe we forgot to get a picture.
I know.
Yes. It's going to happen.
It is going to happen.
It's going to happen. And we hope that happens with a lot of you out there. I hope we get to connect. And please remind us to take a picture.
Yes.
Because I'm the worst remembering to take pictures. I'm just so happy to meet people and talk with them. I don't think about snapping a picture all the time.
Right, right.
So,
I'm the same way. It's
please remind us of that.
Yes.
Well, those are very cool. Thanks, everybody who took part in this. And we'll still accept more. If you want to send us your Disney marvel and wish, what makes you marvel? What makes you say wow about Disney? What do you wish for in 2023, 2024? Let us know. For we will share them on an upcoming show. So thanks once again to everybody who took part in our Disney Marvels and Wishes segment. There's just so many wonderful things that make Disney special, and you know that we can't wait to see what happens in the future and wish for, and some fantastical, amazing things to wish for, and some, you know, like, that could happen.
Right.
We want to make that happen. So
exactly.
We just appreciate you all taking part in that.
Yeah, that was fun. Thank you.
Sure.
Good topic, honey, that you brought up.
Now, before we get to our Disney stories of the week, we have to talk about our great friend Nate with Main Street and More Travel. Because let's face it, we all have trips we're thinking about taking in the very near future. Well, if you do, whether it be to Walt Disney World, Disneyland, Disney Cruise, or anywhere in the world beyond, let me tell you, Nate is the certified Disney vacation planner that you are going to want to get in contact with.
Oh my gosh, for sure. You know, as we, you know, mention all the time, he really has firsthand knowledge of things, so he can really help you plan, customize a trip that is going to be the best for you, answer your questions. It's really concierge level planning that doesn't cost you anything.
High end. It is high end stuff that he will help you out with. Answer all your questions. He is there for you to make sure your trip, wherever it may be the best it possibly can be. And as Michelle mentioned, no extra cost to you. That's because either Disney or whatever other travel branch that he works through pays him for you. What you end up paying is exactly what you pay. If you did all that work yourself, only you can save that time and just relax and enjoy and let him set it all up for you.
Right. And you know what? He may even be able to save you some money from you doing it alone, because he is on top of all the deals and steals that are out there.
Yeah. And there's never a guarantee, but let me tell you, if there's a discount out there, Nate will find it for you. So what you got to do is go to DizTripsAndMore.com, fill out the form there, and just contact him. Talk to him. Tell him what you want to do and let him get to work for you.
Right. So as Tom mentioned, once you fill out that form, Nate will be back in touch with you to start that planning. But be sure to tell him that Tom and Michelle sent you.
Yeah. Again, that's Nate with Main Street and More Travel. All right, let's go ahead and get to the Disney stories of the week. I do have a few for you this week, and I'm going to start with Disney Cruise Line once again takes home some big honors. Mm-hmm. This is from the Disney Parks blog. They said, U.S. News and World Report recently awarded Disney Cruise Line a gold badge in its Best Cruise Line for Families category, while also placing Disney at the top of its Best Cruise Lines in the Caribbean list, both for the 11th year in a row.
Nice. Yeah, well deserved. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, we've experienced that. We've experienced other cruise lines and can totally agree. You know, and one of the things that we say all the time, yes, Disney Cruise Line fares are more expensive than a lot of the other cruise lines, but everything is pretty really included. That on other cruise lines, you have to pay more for things, like even going to a movie.
Right.
Things like that. So.
And there are the intangible things aboard a Disney Cruise Line that you just can't get anywhere else. One thing, we'll just say it right now, there's no other cruise line where you're going to walk around a corner and there's Minnie Mouse.
Right,
you know,
right.
Or there's Rapunzel.
Exactly.
Or whatever it might be. I mean, that just happens when you're aboard a Disney Cruise Line sailing. But, you know, we talked about it when we went our other cruise just a couple months ago and some other things. It's the Disney cast member customer service that you know on land, at sea as well.
Right.
It's top notch. It's you're not going to beat it anywhere. Yes, Michelle mentioned it. You pay a little more, but it's worth paying a little more. They are just set that much more apart.
And if you go on another cruise line, you're going to end up paying more for things that you would get for free on Disney. So it might come out very similar.
Very close.
Say.
Could be. Yeah. Could be. I don't know if it'll be that close, but it still depends on what cruise you're doing, whatever.
And what
else
you do. I mean, like if you like sodas, you get free sodas. You want to do certain activities and movies, it's free. Some of the kids' stuff at other cruise lines, you have to pay for.
Child. There's nothing like being on a Disney cruise, that's for sure.
Yep.
Adding to the accolades, Newsweek has listed Disney Cruise Line among the cruise lines. Among the cruise lines offering America's best customer service, was just talking about that.
Mm-hmm.
And rounding out the honors, the points guy has named Disney Cruise Line as best family cruise line in this year's lineup. So big accolades. Disney Cruise Line deserves it all.
Right.
And so happy to see that they are continuing to be on top of the list. Continue to be
getting that recognition.
Spectacular. Mm-hmm. We have cruise coming up in March.
Yeah.
Marvel Day at Sea.
That's
can't
right.
wait for that. That's going to be exciting
for
sure. We have to work out all our outfits for that.
I know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Some of us may already have ideas.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Well, Michelle's Marvel ideas are always the best.
I don't know about that. I'm going to ease you into some of the ideas.
Oh, boy. Can I be Miss Marvel?
Maybe. I think we need to get our consultants, Pat and Charles, to help us out some of these plans.
Oh, boy. They're going to start charging for us for this.
Maybe so,
They might be asking royalties just for all the mentions we give them.
True. We're done.
That's it. We're cutting you off. We're talking about Marvel. We talked a lot about Disney Marvels in today's show. Well, your chance to for your own Marvels experience is happening at Disney parks around the globe.
Mm-hmm.
This again from the Disney Parks blog. They said, for a limited time, guests may encounter Carol Danvers, Kamala Khan, and Captain Monica Rambeau as they make a high-spirited entrance together in Avengers Campus in Disney California Adventure Park to recruit the next generation of superheroes. With superheroes from across the universe continuing to arrive at Avengers Campus, recruits never knew who they may run into. It's one of those magnificent things about Avengers Campus. It's a living, breathing space that whenever a series is going on, a movie comes out, that you can pretty much expect there may be somebody from that or somebody in a different outfit or whatever it might be that's going to make an appearance out there.
Exactly.
It's one of the things we love about Avengers Campus.
Yeah, one of the many things, but yes.
Mm-hmm.
Can't wait for Pim's Kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's going to be so much fun. So, I'd love to do a meet and greet with all of them.
Ooh,
we have done a meet and greet with Captain Marvel in the past, but we've obviously never done with Miss Marvel, Kamala Khan, or with Captain Monica Rambeau, who is Photon. Have not met them yet, so that would be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Sure, I hope they're still, when we get out there in January, still doing meet and greets. I don't know, that might be too far out, but we can hope.
Yep.
We can hope.
You can wish.
Mm-hmm. The Marvels recently took to the skies above Disneyland Paris for a very special limited time show ahead of the jaw-dropping nighttime Avengers Power the Night drone show. This was all made possible through Disneyland Paris's official technology supplier, Dronisos. Okay. A pioneering drone entertainment company specializing in the creation of indoor and outdoor drone shows. With state-of-the-art projections, pyrotechnics, and up to 500 drones, Avengers Power of the Night is a high-tech Avengers spectacular never seen before in any Disney park. We've seen videos and photos from
God,
it. It looks
amazing.
Fantastic.
Yes. Yeah. And it would seem to fit going to California to have a drone show, because I know with fire risks that there are a lot of times that fireworks can't be you know, projected out there. They do great other ways of making the nighttime shows fun. But I think they could really benefit from a drone show.
Yeah, I wonder if they have limitations at Disneyland, California, because of
the airspace.
Because they're right, like, there's part of it, like, if you go and it's like, there's like a neighborhood, like, right next door.
True.
Like, you know, is there an issue with flying these things over neighborhoods and
that's
stuff?
That's a good point.
That maybe that's an issue. I don't know.
Right. All right, then Disney World.
I just wonder.
Walt Disney World. We'll take it here.
Yeah, I don't know. You know why we haven't seen? I'm really surprised we have not seen drone shows more in the U.S. But maybe
I read somewhere. I don't know how much it was a rumor versus real. I can't even remember the source, but it sounded like there's some, at least some blue sky review of having a drone show in the United States.
I think it'll be a lot of fun. I think that they can be very creative with those and would look forward to checking that out at some point.
Exactly.
Also, having fulfilled her dream of meeting her own hero, Carol Danvers, Kamala Khan heads to Disneyland Paris for the first time ever, where you can meet her at Avengers Campus. Next, head to the Hero Training Center to perfect your skills in a training session led by Carol, then help her and Iron Man save the world in the thrilling Avengers Assemble Flight Force.
Nice.
Sounds fun.
Mm-hmm.
Fly over to Skyline Bar at Disney Hotel New York, the Art of Marvel, to recharge with limited edition cocktails inspired by the superpowers and cosmic mix-up from the film. They're called Photon Blast and Cosmic Entanglement. Did we mention? They're delicious. I'm sure of it.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Look forward to try that. At Hong Kong Disneyland, guests there can will also have the opportunity to meet Kamala Khan, who has recently released her voice. She gets all over the place. Man, she can zip all around.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
She's got superpowers, honey.
Who has recently started visiting the resort for the first time at the Tomorrowland stage from now until November 19th. So not very long. Mm. Guests will also have the chance to meet Kamala together with one of the universe's most powerful superheroes, a.k.a. Carol Danvers in Tomorrowland. At the Shanghai Disney Resort, Carol's hero work takes her around the world, including to the Shanghai Disney Resort. During the Avengers Training Initiative, members of the Avengers and their field agents assemble prospective recruits at the Pepsi E stage in Tomorrowland. New recruits have the chance to train with Carol and other favorite superheroes to see if they're fit to become the next generation of Avengers agents.
Nice.
Sounds fun.
Mm-hmm.
The heroes from the Marvels are also defenders of the Seven Seas.
What?
Yeah, taking place at the Worlds of Marvel restaurant aboard the Disney Wish with Avengers Quantum Encounter. Throughout dinner, of course, guests take part in a hands-on demonstration of the latest and greatest PIM tech hosted by Ant-Man and the Wasp. But this tech is so advanced that it attracts a very unwelcome visitor to the Disney Wish. Of course, we're talking about Ultron.
Right.
Captain America and Carol Danvers arrive just in time to take on the army of Ultron sentries in an Avengers-level battle on the upper decks of the ship. With them is hero in training, Kamala Khan, again, he's everywhere, who puts her cosmic powers to the test alongside some of her favorite Avengers while totally fangirling the whole time, kind of like me, totally fangirling the whole time.
So funny. Oh, great.
I think it's great. I love that all the characters are going to be all across the globe, like
right,
I said. And
yes.
So many of the different Disney parks and cruise lines.
Right, right. Yeah, so Disney experiences. Yes.
Yes. So great. So that's awesome. Finally, if you're looking for an extravagant, upscale way to spend New Year's Eve beyond the looking glass at the Walt Disney World Resort, we've got the party for you. Not for your bank account, but for you. This is straight from the Walt Disney World website. They said, ring in the new year with a fantastical evening. Enjoy shimmering champagne, delightful wines, marvelous food, and one-of-a-kind entertainment by immersing yourself in the whimsical surroundings of California Grill, transformed into an immersive romp through Wonderland. You may see characters from Alice's Adventures in Wonderland throughout the evening.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
They say, get your camera ready. You'll come face to face with the doorknob in the entryway. Then keep your eyes peeled for Alice, the Mad Hatter, the March Hare in the dining room. You may also get a chance to wave hello to Dinah, the Hat Lady. But beware of the Queen of Hearts.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, the line for Alice and the Queen of Hearts at the Run Disney race last week was like one of the longest lines I've ever seen in a Run Disney race for any character.
For anything, yes.
It will surely be a merry party complete with custom crafted cocktails, We hope you come dressed in your best and be ready to dance because their DJ, who happens to be the White Rabbit, has curated an upbeat music fest. Plus, they'll cap the evening and start 2024 with a fantastic champagne toast at midnight. But now, let's get to the real thing of this party because the food sounds phenomenal. They're delicious dishes. As you float between the rooms, you'll find food stations inspired by Lewis Carroll's imaginative stories. Indulge in delicious seafood, including delectable caviar, with their chef's creative twist. So I'm not going to give you everything, but I'm going to give you several things. Here are the menu highlights from this party. They have a chilled appetizer station with a chilled seafood bar. Caviar, as we just mentioned. Wagyu beef tartare and ice wine winter salad. Right there. That's good enough for me.
I know. Right there. I know.
I don't need anything more.
I don't know. We may have to go to this.
Yeah. They have a wood-burning pizza station. They have a sushi station. They have a hot seafood station with serving adobo marinated octopus, lobster ravioli, and seared ahi tuna. From the grill and rotisserie, they have pork belly porchetta, which is a kind of a rolled pork belly thing. Very good. Royal beef tenderloin and roasted duck two ways. And finally, to cap it all off, sweet treats from the pastry chefs at the Disney's Contemporary Resort, including pavlova, lemon, thyme, shortbread, blackberry lavender tart, strawberry and blackberry mousse. All sounds delicious.
Yes. Ooh. Sounds wonderful. It's all you very can, tempting.
All you want to
right.
take in, all you want to enjoy. They say so much more. Who knows what else is there, but that menu sounds fantastic. Finally, experience the first moments of 2024 as the fireworks spectacular from Magic Kingdom Park fills the sky above. And, of course, they've mentioned that champagne toast. The event information, of course, it's on December 31st, 2023. Check-in time begins at 7 p.m. The event time, it runs from 7:30 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. Now, here's where you may not want to go.
What?
The price, the cost for this experience is $799 per guest.
Wow.
But here's the good news.
Yes.
Tax and gratuity is included in that price. So not so bad. if that didn't deter you, you want to make reservations for this, you can do it by calling 407-824-2013. Guests under 18 years of age must have a parent or guardian's permission to call. Why would anybody under 18, who under 18 years of age has $800?
Right.
Just book this thing because you need to pay for it at your time of booking in full.
Wow.
You can cancel at least one prior day to it, but otherwise you'll be charged full price. But you need, when you book it, you need to pay for it on that spot. It's not like a deposit.
Right.
And pay for it later. You need to pay for it then. If you're a kid under 18 who has more than $800, God bless you.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah, but get your parents' permission to book that. But still, that sounds like an amazing party.
Yes, yes. I once was so lucky to be able to go to one of the most amazing New Year's Eve parties at Walt Disney World. It was Beauty and the Beast theme. When you first walked in, it was in a ballroom. And when you first walked in, you went through a forest. They had created a forest that you'd walk through and it had like you know, fog and stuff like that. And then you went into Gaston's Tavern, have some cocktails there. Then you went into where the dinner was, and it was a dinner show where the performers for Beauty and the Beast were serving you. Then you had a dessert buffet after midnight, some dancing. And then when you left, they gave you a little bag with a bagel and cream cheese. And the newspaper saying January 1st.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So when they, and I'm only saying this, that when they put on a New Year's Eve party, they do it up big and it's just impressive.
Yeah.
Beyond words.
I would think that this would be, I don't know if it's going to be quite to that level, but it's probably.
It sounds like
pretty
it's
good.
Similar,
it's pretty close. But that menu alone is.
Yes.
I mean, to try and get that in a restaurant. You're going to be paying $600,
right.
You know, to go to Victoria and Albert's or whatever, you
yes.
know, for something like that. So pretty amazing. Again, it's probably out of our our price range a little bit.
Right,
and most of yours price range, but that's still pretty darn cool.
Yes.
And if you do decide to splurge and go, please let us know all about it.
Right. Because, yeah.
That sounds phenomenal.
Yeah. We'll interview you about your experience.
For sure. For sure. Just a couple other quick hits I want to talk about. World of Color 1 at Disney California Adventure Park will be closed for refurbishment from January 8th through February 29th, 2024. We were a little disappointed to hear this because that's when our trip is.
Right.
But just wanted to let you know in case you have Disney plans that you may want to adjust your schedule if you're hoping to see a World of Color 1. Also, and we love this. This could have been one of my favorite things from this week. Disney and Pixar's Inside Out 2 trailer dropped this week. And apparently it had 157 million views in 24 hours, beating out Frozen 2 to become the biggest animated trailer launch in Disney history.
Wow.
I guess 78 million of those views were on TikTok, which they kind of put out a big thing on social media this week that Disney and TikTok are kind of pairing up more to do many, many, many more things.
Right.
So kind of interesting. Yeah. The film will be in the theaters on June 14th of 2024. So and the trailer was cute.
Yeah, definitely.
Looked just like, you know, we loved Inside Out, the first one. I'm very excited to see Inside Out 2.
For sure. Yeah.
Very good. So that's it for the Disney stories of the week. However, we never leave you without giving you some sort of tip that might help you on your next vacation. And when we do this, we always start with Michelle because she's wonderful, fantastic, all things great and marvelous in the world. You know she does the best research. You hear that regularly. She definitely has the best list. You heard a little bit of that earlier today. One thing is for very certain, she always has the very best tips. So let's get to it. Here is Michelle's tip of the week.
You're funny. So my tip, I mean, usually in my tips, I'm not giving you a tip of how to spend more money because I already know going to the parks is definitely an expensive excursion a lot of times. But these are some things you might not know. I mean, I think a lot of people know how you can build your own lightsaber or droid. But, you know, when you ride the Banshees on Flight of Passage, you know how they transform you into an avatar? Well, how would you like to create your own avatar that you could take home? Well, you can do that at Wind Traders in Animal Kingdom. You can pose for your own 3D avatar action figure. Action figure, honey. To be created. Even says it on the in the stuff. So one of the things to keep in mind if you want to do this, you don't need to have a reservation. You just go to the Ace Avatar Maker booth in Wind Traders. But keep in mind that it may take you a little while to do all your selections and everything and to take the actual imagery. So they say estimate about like 20 minutes. And then it may take about an hour before your avatar is actually completed. But let's say that avatars aren't your thing. Perhaps you might want to see yourself created as a Tron-inspired action figure. Well, you can do that over at Tomorrowland's Launch Depot. And you get to decide, are you going to be will your program be an enforcer or a combatant, a scout or a heavy sentry? And you get to select your team color too. Launch Depot, you visit the command input and you will be able to also include 6 lines of dialogue of your own voice with your Tron action figure. So again, it may take 20 to 30 minutes to scan and make your choices and then an hour to complete. But some pretty cool additional souvenirs you might want to consider.
Very cool. That's awesome. Yeah. All right. Definitely something that you'll always be able to keep around and have memories of your flight on a Banshee or, you know, riding the light cycles in Tron.
Right.
For sure.
Right.
Very cool.
Have your own action figure. Yes. Doll.
Yes. Very good. Very good. So I like that. Michelle's tip. Always the best tip. My tip, you know, we're getting ready. We're making plans for Disneyland. And I wanted to remind some people that, you know, just like at Walt Disney World Resort, if you're staying at a Disneyland, a Disney hotel, we're talking about their three, the Grand Californian, the Disneyland Hotel, or Paradise Pier, which I think is Paradise Pier. Still changing to a Pixar theme. It's not completely done yet, but it's changing to a Pixar theme. Any of those, you do get early entry into the parks, both of them right now, currently as we speak. Right. 30 minutes before opening time, you get to get into the parks and try and knock out some of those extremely popular attractions, get in there early. So you'll want to take advantage of that. Now, here's one thing you want to know is that that is going to be changing slightly once we get to January 20th of next year, 2024. It's going to be going back to where it was pre-pandemic. I don't know if you remember this, or maybe you've never visited Disneyland, but it would alternate parks and what parks you could go into on a daily basis early. So that's what's going to happen once we get to January 20th of 2024. They will be, one day it'll be Disneyland Park, one day it'll be California Adventure Park that you will be able to go in early. So they haven't put up the calendar yet for what days are going to be for which park.
Right.
But since you still will have to make park reservations, as far as we know, up until that point, it might be good to know which park to make the reservation at. If you happen to be staying at, I mean, you're paying a pretty penny to be staying in those Disney hotels. You want to take advantage of every perk there is.
Sure.
That 30 minutes can be very helpful if you want to get on Space Mountain or Haunted Mansion.
Right.
Or some of these, you know, big attractions that are tough to get onto, or you might have to wait
a
significant time. That 30 minutes extra is going to help you significantly. You'll want to know which park is when. So plan out accordingly. Keep an eye on that calendar for when they release those dates.
Exactly. Good tip.
Thank you. So that's it for this week's show. Next week, well, we'll be talking about DVC resorts that aren't directly associated with a theme park. We're talking about Disney's Aulani Resort, Disney's Hilton Head Island Resort, and of course, Disney's Vero Beach Resort, which we love very much.
Right.
But, you know, the one issue is we've only been to Disney's Vero Beach Resort. We could talk about that all day. That's fine. We haven't actually experienced the other two yet. Good news is we know somebody who has. So our plan is to bring on our favorite certified Disney vacation planner, Nate, to come on, because he happens to have visited Disney's Aulani Resort. He has happened to have visited Disney's Hilton Head Island Resort.
Right.
And he can tell us what's great about those places, or if they're even worth visiting, whether it's worth, hey, maybe putting on my list. You know, the theme parks are great.
Right.
Maybe I want to go visit someplace else that is still, but still get that Disney feel.
Right.
We could sell you on Vero Beach Resort all day, and we will.
Yes.
But we're also going to talk with Nate about those other magnificent resorts.
Which will be a lot of fun.
It will be a lot of fun. Plus, it's just great to have Nate on, because Nate's such a good guy.
And yes,
it'll be fun to talk with him. Also, I want to hear about his, because he just got done last weekend with doing the Run Disney Challenge.
Right.
Doing the 10K and the half marathon. So I'll hear about that.
Yes.
And he's got another trip planned that I want to hear a little bit about too. Ooh. That we will talk about. So anyway, great stuff. Looking forward to talking with Nate next week. As for this week's show, we appreciate that you joined us today. In the future, you can find us most everywhere you get podcasts. However, the very best place to find us is on our own website, HyperionAdventuresPodcast.com. Also, we are on social media. We are on Twitter at Hyperion Podcast, Facebook, Instagram, and Threads at Hyperion Adventures Podcast. If you are on Facebook, come on over and join us for some good, positive Disney energy fun on our Hyperion Adventurers Facebook group. Also, we're on YouTube. If you want to find us there, we're at Hyperion Adventurers Podcast. And if you ever want to contact us for any reason, please hit us up at our Gmail account, HyperionAdventuresPodcast@gmail.com.
And as we mentioned earlier in this episode, we really do appreciate our listeners so much. And so if there's somebody that you know that isn't listening, we'd love for you to invite them to join along and listen to and participate with us through social media.
For sure. Just give them a nod and say, hey, you know, you might like this show. You know, maybe not, but give it a try.
Yes.
Why not? What can it hurt?
They're weird people.
They are weird people. And if you like weird people, then we're the people for you.
Right.
Weird positive people.
Yes.
Weirdly positive people.
Probably true.
Yes. Anyway, thank you for listening to another episode of the Hyperion Adventures Podcast. We look forward to sharing some time with you again next week. Until that time, I'm Tom.
I'm Michelle.
And we hope that you have a magical week.
Bye.